Hello all. I finally wrapped up the restoration on this beautiful Sears Roebuck & Company Silvertone Model 4569 from 1936. It's a beautiful Art Deco cabinet design with a gold round dial. So I wanted to share a few of the still photos and then the radio playing. This video is a takeoff from the previous video where I had sprayed all the clear lacquers and I said I wanted the lacquer to cure for a week or two. So 2 weeks have passed and then this weekend I spent time rubbing out the finish. In the last video I received some positive comments about the finish and I was kind of mixed if I wanted to go with a high gloss, more of a piano finish or more of a semi-gloss finish. And honestly, I've never had a radio in my collection where I did a finish and kept it more of a closer to a piano finish or high gloss. In this case, you can see I ended up going that way. So I got some great feedback from Zine of Clarity 1969. So if you're watching this video, thanks for your comment about keeping it high gloss. I think after spending some time and taking in the design, the Art Deco design of the radio, and how beautiful the cabinet is, I think the high gloss is more fitting for this particular style. In the last video, one thing that was very obvious was the overspray and the orange peel. So the objective of the rub out, again, was to remove those impairments. So to get rid of the overspray, I started with some 4-0 steel wool, using some Wool-Lube and went over the entire cabinet, followed by wet sanding. And the grits were a little bit different based on the amount of orange peel. In some locations I used a 600 grit, some others I went straight to 1000. But I progressed through 600, 800, 1000, 1500, 2000, and then followed up with pumice and rotten stone. Just a little housekeeping left. I need to pick up some brown felt, place that around the control stems, and give the knobs one final polish. And you probably noticed here in the video, I did use the original grill cloth for now. I think it really adds some character, so I'll probably just leave it as is for now. This radio, in particular the radio cabinet itself, really presented some unique challenges. All the veneer work that had to be done with the inlay at the bottom and have it match the top was something I've never done before. So it was a lot of trial and error, but I'm really very happy with the outcome. Really proud of the way it turned out and the way it looks. For those of you that followed along, thanks for doing so. I appreciate my new subscribers out there as well. So let's listen to the radio play here, a little bit on the broadcast band, followed by the shortwave.
Broke through the line. I'm not sure if it was a blitz or not, but he came through right away. And you have to tackle Hilleman. He does not go down easy. He's a slasher type runner.
They are short of the 20, and they actually do have to get.
Back when in psychology, there used to be a sign of
association. Looking at a 2-1 hockey game. We got a little late start tonight due to the Notre Dame game rolling late. So if you just joining us, the scratches for the Commons tonight, CJ Shepherd was the scratch along with.
Notre Dame 55.
simple.
Very nicely, a very unique style, flavor, and Joey.
And that will be it, and A&M will celebrate here.
Hace unos años descubrí que existía la Asociación Cubana de Deportes Electrónicos.
Beneath the surface, that is what Jesus was...
Honey, don't beat yourself.